We have a treat for you now. We have Giovanni Maruzzelli. He's the principal at opentelecom.it.
So
he develops software. I'm not done with you yet. You've got way more build up before your talk. We're going to build you up so high that you fly over the stage. He develops software and training courses for FreeSWITCH, SIP, WebRTC, and Camaleo. He wrote the FreeSWITCH interface with Skype and cellular phones, mod GSM, if anyone remembers. He's going to be talking to us about how to use FreeSWITCH, a SIP proxy, and FusionPBX to build any kind of high-traffic SIP B2BUA service. Title of his talk is FusionPBX and FreeSWITCH as a Toolkit for High-Traffic, Scalable SIP Services. Give Giovanni a round of applause.
As Travis described, seems very, very interesting speech. I don't know, because it comes more for what is our practical need as implementers when we have a new customer that really needs some big service, and for example, they are brokering back and forth between different carriers, or they can do trunking or whatever. So we know how to do that. We use some SIP proxy, we use some B2B if we need to. And then this is done. I mean, this is what our customer needs. So we solved their problem. That's actually not completely true, because what our customer need is not only the basic technology to have the packets back and forth, but they need also capability to manage this service and to authorize their people to do configuration changes, to do monitoring, to do statistics on how this particular service is going, and all these kind of things. So there is an important part in each kind of service that is not just SIP and just packets going back and forth. Is all that has to do with the web management, the interface, the administration, so on and so forth, and the interface to the database. And we are in the situation that we have to write all this, and this probably will take an awful amount of time, because our customer, maybe not the technical director, but for sure his report and his marketing people, the only things that they will see will be the graphical interface, will be the web interface. So will not be our shining packet switching platform, but they will just see some buttons and some screen. And our solution will be evaluated also for this, and they will operate this day in and day out. So it's important to have some toolkit that allows us to give a complete solution that we have not to write from scratch each time. So enter FusionPBX. FusionPBX is an interface to manage FreeSWITCH, and that makes FreeSWITCH a very advanced enterprise-grade PBX. But we will not use it as PBX, because we are building a brokering system for an ITSP, for example. And so we will take some module from Fusion, we will adapt to our usage, and we will see that in a very short time, we are able to give our solution an interface for management, for giving access, for giving responsibilities, that allows us to dramatically cut our development time. Fusion PBX has been developed since more than 10 years, is very, very stable and very actively developed. And by the way, his main developer is Mark Crane, that won last year Dangerous Demo with James Body, and in packing his own Fusion PBX into a bubble plastic and throwing around while it was setting it up. So I ask for a big applause for Mark Crane and Fusion also, because they're a good system. So a rapid screenshots from Fusion, and you can see that we have all the building blocks that we need. So let's say, let's call this one just a mask to interrogate, to query and display database rows. And this is a page that will plot some series on your screen. And this is a drill down that is able to show you the result of a query. And what we want to do is get these capabilities that are already oriented toward services and telco services, and route them to our part. Each, let's say, each voice into the menu, its item into the menus, are a separate app. This app is just a directory into the Fusion PBX code. You get one of those directories, you copy it with another name, then you search and substitute all the names inside the single files, and you have a copy that is working just with a new name. Then you just modify it and use it for your own purposes. For example, you can have in this way just a new interface to give route to numbers that are incoming and outcoming, for example, to distribute the IDs or whatever. And Fusion has this that is very important, that is completely different from whatever other, let's call it, toolkit you can use. Fusion has been developed to be a very thin layer on top of FreeSWITCH. So we know FreeSWITCH, and we are able to modify and to repurpose each module of Fusion to do the things that we need with FreeSWITCH. It's a very thinly veil on top of FreeSWITCH, but it gives us a lot of things that are already made. And this, for example, is how you structure a dial plan, and is exactly like in the XML of the FreeSWITCH configuration. So condition, action, anti-action, et cetera, et cetera. And This is the procedure how you build a new app. So basically, you copy one of the existing app, you change the names, you change the logic, and boom. Probably in one day, you have at least the prototype of your new item in the menus. And I will pass by the technical details. You can then check them into the slides that I will make available. But this is one of the most important things that your customers want, you want, and made your solution an industrial-grade solution. You are able to create users for this solution, administrator, domains, subdomains, groups, and each one of this group, of this user, of this admin, will have special permission. And those permissions are very granular. For example, this particular field in this particular database will be able to be edited by admin, but will be to only be read by the normal user, etc., etc. You can create how many roles you want, and you can assign each user to each role or each group. So it's very fine-grained, and you can, in this way, really, for example, get to yourself or to your company all the power to do most important things, and then delegate to your customer all that is related to his own day-to-day operation, and your customer will be able autonomously to delegate things, for example, to his own customers, things that are less and less and less important. So you will end up having a different tiers of responsibilities and organization. But one of the most important things is that you are also able, I don't know in which slide it is, but you will have a complete tracking of who has done what, because Fusion has incorporated a function, an audit function, that will give you a complete listing of all database transactions, who has modified what and in what way. So what was the value before, what was the value after, when it was modified, and by who. And with all the historical trail. So this is very important when you work with big organizations. And so the organization of your service will be our standard technology. So you will have your proxy that will be highly available, your proxy for RTP and media that will be highly available. You will have a Redis or something like in the middle that will allow you to drop the calls, but to just move on the backup. And you will have your farm of FreeSWITCHs and B2B user agents with all the background of cluster of PostgreSQL or MariaDB and the file system cluster. And you, from this kind of architecture, will be able to use Fusion and all the services that the Fusion gives to you to dramatically shorten and package in a complete way your service for your customers. So this presentation was mainly about not so much our own technology, how to switch packets, how to delve into SDP, etc. I've done plenty of them, but was more like offering from our practical experience some gem that has been very precious to arrive to the complete solution that is not made only by the core technology, but is made for a very important part, also for the managing and presentation part. So I ready to accept questions.
You don't show phone registrations. How do you control, like, inter, you know, SIP communication, say, you know, extension 100 lands on the first free switch and extension 101 ends on the second free switch? How do they dial each other?
Maybe I've not understood the question.
Well, like, in this, like, so normally in a fusion cluster, they like to do like a hot and a spare standby, right? So in this environment, you know, if you've got, you know, multiple phones registered on all these different PBXs in the cluster on the back side, like, are you taking the free switch database and like putting that out also into the cluster and the Postgres so that when you call, like, you know, 101 and you're registered to the first free switch on the bottom and they're registered to another
is It's not that at all. First of all, this is not a topology for a PBX. But apart from that, if this will be a PBX, what you do is you have the phones on, let's say, on the left, outside from the trunks. The phones register on the proxy. So the proxy is just one. They are in high availability. So they register on the proxy. The proxy will send the registration once in a while to the back end, one of whatever free switches of the farm. And that will stay in the database that is shared by all the free switches. So it will be registered by all free switches. If a call comes for this registered user, it will be answered from whatever one of the free switches. If a second call comes from that user, or if that user originates another call, you need to have those two calls on the same machine, because you want to transfer, you want to mix, whatever. So the important thing is that you put this kind of algorithms on the proxy, so the proxy knows, okay, there is a current call in some of the free switches for this user. I get another call, okay, I will send to the same machine. That's, but this is for PBXs. In these cases, we were talking more about wholesale services, etc. Definitely. But I think that using this kind of architecture is really an enable for startup, for operator, for ITSPs, etc. Because this is, I mean, you can start with, let's say, 9 virtual machines on some system that is high available. And then you can just grow. And you have really something that is a complete solution, because you have the proxy that will demultiply and will keep a security and will keep a DMZ, etc. And then you have your farm on the back, and you have your cluster of databases and your file system on cluster. So all those things are all available, and you just throw more machines and they grow horizontally. So it's maybe a little bit tough to understand just on the beginning, but this takes 1 week, just to understand that you don't want to have, for example, registration and FreeSWITCH on the same machine. So to send directly the registration from the phone through the proxy to the FreeSWITCH. But to have the proxy to demultiply the registrations and to take care of this decoupling. So just allows you to grow much better with very little added complication.
Any other questions for Giovanni? Going once, going twice. Then let's give 3 big rounds of applause to Giovanni.
By the way, this is the 10th year, so it's 10 years that I'm doing these speeches, and I'm very, very, very happy, and I want to thank Tony, Brian, Mike, Travis, Sharon, Darren, Abby, and all that is giving us the possibility to get together, see friends, get drunk, eat good food, all those things, and advanced technology.